In a bid to combat the surge in plastic pollution in Lake Victoria, NGO Giz has started an initiative to remove and control waste on Lake Victoria and teach the fishermen on how to recycle waste.
And let them collect waste at the landing sites. Now, we did not only want to collect waste, we connect them to recycling companies, you know?
Adolf Gassel, the GIZ country representative, said that the German government has allocated funds that will be used to support the Ministry of Water and Environment in strengthening regulation, increasing performance of utilities, and extending services to the urban poor.
International Development and Cooperation has made available funds to help people to cope with increased cost of living. You know, the food prices have gone up for reasons beyond our control in Uganda.
According to Rose Basoma, the project coordinator, the program will cover around 34 districts and 34 landing sites, especially those around Lake Victoria and Kyoga.
And so far we've collected 50 tons. We've moved in 32 districts on 34 landing sites, and we've collected 50 tons of waste. All of it has been taken to be recycled. We don't burn anything. We don't support burning of any waste.
Currently, more than 2,000 fishermen and ladies have received training in waste management. Funds have also been available to women to start up small businesses.
So far, in terms of mobilization, we are working together with the leadership around the communities to talk to people, to come together and learn about the importance of the impacts of poor solid waste disposal.
Herbert Mukisa has encouraged residents to learn recycling of waste. He emphasized that his business can help them improve their livelihoods. Charles Nsenge, a resident, has asked the residents to shun poor disposal of garbage, emphasizing that the habit leads to pollution of the lakes and the environment.
The
rapid urbanization of small towns bordering Lake Victoria has had a severe impact on the lake's water quality and its ecosystem, in addition to placing enormous pressure on the capacity of the towns to provide adequate water and sanitation services for their growing populations. Report by Godfrey Sempija in Jinja.